as we present our featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Straight Out Promotions in association with Corona, La Cerveza Más Fina, and Showtime. This bout, by the way, is sanctioned by the Kentucky Athletic Commission. The chairman is Mike Cunningham, commissioners Ballard Cassidy and Paula McClellan. Our physicians at ringside, Dr. Jack Walk and Dr. Mark Wheeler. Timekeeper at the bell is John Cooper. Keeping count of the knockdowns, Hector Falu Mendoza. Jumping at ringside for our main event, from Owensboro, Kentucky, Dan McClellan. From Louisville, Kentucky, Johnny Monson. And also from Louisville, we have Steve Ryan. Introducing at this time our third man in the ring, the referee in charge of this bout. He'll be giving instructions after the introductions, Dennis Alfred. Our fans, here we go with our main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing scheduled in a heavyweight special attraction. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Louisville, Kentucky, it's Showtime! Introducing to you first, ladies and gentlemen, on my left, he is fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring, wearing white trunks with red trim, and joining us from London, England. He weighed in at 265 pounds. His record stands at 31 wins, 3 losses, with 26 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the former British and British Commonwealth heavyweight champion, introducing Danny Williams. And his opponent across the ring on my right, fighting out of the red corner, really needing no introduction the world over. Entering the ring, wearing his traditional black trunks and hailing from Catskill, New York. He weighed in at 233 pounds. His record, 50 wins, 4 losses, 2 no contests, with 44 wins coming by way of knockout. He is currently ranked the number 8 heavyweight by the WBC. Tonight, he is making his return to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. Please welcome the one and only Iron Mike Tyson. Once again, a referee in charge, Dennis Alfred. Now the instructions, 10 rounds of boxing scheduled.
Gentlemen, we went over the rules in the dressing rooms. I expect a good, clean bout. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands. You're good about here? You're good here. Y'all have any questions? Touch them up. Let's go to work.
Certainly the calmest we've seen Mike Tyson before a fight. For the record, 22 of Tyson's 44 knockouts in round one, including his last fight, 49 seconds in. His fastest knockout, 30 seconds in, against Marvis Frazier almost exactly 18 years ago, July 26th of 1986. Danny Williams feels Tyson will rush in to try and take him out early. What else is new? But Freddie Root, coach, told us he's trying to prevent that. He wants Mike to go behind the jab, rip to Williams' body. We'll see. There's the bell. We're underway. And Danny Williams goes right in and looks to trade. And that could be a huge mistake. Tyson going right to the body.
Jab and lay that right hand behind it, and of course the uppercut again, something he looks for from Williams. And he wants to tie Tyson up on the inside. They've been working on that, and we'll see how effectively he can do it.
Once again, Tyson looking belting in the midsection. Being cautioned by the third man of the ring, Dennis Alford, to keep the punches up. These are vicious punches by Tyson.
Look out, Matt.
Tyson's working well on the inside. Now, Dennis Alford, he pointed out he's been a referee for 25 years, but he's never had a world championship fight. He's never been in a fight of this magnitude. And boy, referees are tested in Mike Tyson fights for a variety of reasons.
Andy Williams, no stranger to fouling. He just used his elbow. He's been cited for low blows in a couple of fights back in England. Tyson, digging to the body, left hook to the jaw. Has been wide open. His elbows are high. Tyson inside to the body.
There's the jab of Williams, and when he throws it, he's able to get that punch in. And he's leaning into Tyson a lot, and that's giving Mike Tyson a chance to land those shots.
That's a head movement by Tyson. Pushing him back, using your strength.
Your hands now.
He has landed some very good shots in there. And this round did
his boss.
Can he sustain that? And can Tyson sustain?
Final seconds of round two.
Tyson,
able to take matters in his own hands. But Danny Williams.
shuffle around.
10 seconds.
Oh, what a left hand. That set was off balance. And then Tyson just missing at the bell. Here, Tyson using his head on the inside. That may have been where, ironically, he caused his own eye to get cut. Williams very frustrated with that use of the head and this use of the head. And at the end of the sequence, he punches Tyson. And this is what Dennis Alford would look at and decide was a punch late after the break took a point away from Williams. Then later on in the round, a left hook that looked like it was right on the belt line called for a low blow, another point deducted from Williams.
Both have cuts. You see the cut around the right eye of Mike Tyson. I don't think the blood is going into his eye as we had a round four.
Same time, so both men are landing bombs.
Some resounding shots by Tyson. Now Williams going back to the jab. Tyson answers with a jab of his own. Tyson trying to land with that uppercut. And now Williams hangs on. And hearing it again from the crowd. Tyson missing with a left quick attempt.
Yeah!
for him. Mike Tyson had no answer, and once Williams put him down, there was very little sign that Tyson was going to get up. He did finally struggle up after what appeared to be a pretty long count. And as he laid against these ropes, we might finally say that we've seen the end of the road for Mike Tyson. And this delayed the count even more as Danny Williams took a while to get to his corner. And still, though Tyson made an effort to get up, he didn't beat the count.
A disastrous night for Mike Tyson. Disastrous.
And this was an exciting heavyweight fight. That's exactly what it turned into. Williams hurt early, as you see, coming back to win this fight. The combinations here are what is really pretty impressive. And how about the way he's mixing his attack to the body and the head? And we talked in advance of that uppercut. You knew that punch was effective for Danny Williams, and he showed Tyson that it was. That right hand from Tyson was the last sign of offense that he would show in this fight.
Tyson manhandled, looked like a rag doll at the end. How about that look on his face?
A surprise that Danny Williams was able to hang in there till the fourth round and get it done.
Last time I saw that face was against Buster Douglas. Maybe Lennox Lewis.
We see the work by Danny Williams. That uppercut, it was his key to winning this fight, and it turned out the body work was as well. And Tyson really tired in the fourth round. He started to get a little bit fatigued. He had thrown what he could throw early in the fight, had Williams hurt, but here, Danny Williams just throwing combination, punch after punch, Tyson without a defense, and you see, the reason he can do this to Tyson is, instead of throwing left hooks that are going to miss, he throws effective uppercuts. That's the punch you have to use against Mike Tyson. Lennox Lewis used it. Danny Williams came in with that punch in his arsenal, and it's what allowed him to get the job done. That and the fact that Mike Tyson just got tired in the fourth round.
Yeah, he's just flat fatigued. You could see it. It was obvious. He was flat-footed. And then he got pummeled to the deck. And the look of resignation on Mike Tyson's face tells it all.
And even though the count may have gone a little long still, Mike Tyson was not ready to get up and couldn't get up. This may have ended very quickly, this latest reincarnation of Mike Tyson's career.
Are we looking at the end of a career? Jimmy Lennon Jr. has the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time. 2 minutes, 51 seconds in round number four. Our referee in charge, Dennis Alfred, reaches the count of 10. He's the winner by way of a stunning knockout, Danny Williams.